people are organizing in your neighborhood, so First Baptist Coalition is having sister projects, and a lot of citywide groups are fighting around, like Jennifer was talking about, around rent laws, fighting for no more evictions, for rent council, and looking at like building the power of the grassroots to say, like, how do we get to the place to say not one more person moves? And we all deserve to live here and to fight back and to change the laws to reflect our dignity, as opposed to having laws that facilitate the maximization of profits.
Thank you. Okay, so we're to our last and final question. Organizing saved the Bronx, but we never hear that story. Very much about the fires either. What is the power in telling our own stories?
No, it's my question, but I have to be honest and transparent. The film started out as like a policy film, and Gretchen here kept pushing me to tell my story about that, and it was hard. So part of the, on the other side of it, the power is that now I know my history more than ever before. I thought I did, I also didn't know. And now I feel like I have a voice to speak to the issues that I care about, and my life, the life of my children. I think it's important to also share with the community our history, that it came from us. We interviewed a lot of people from the neighborhood, and so I feel comfortable that it is our history. And I feel that, for example, last week we were in the South Bronx doing a screening, and it was important for me that those people in that room felt like that I had gotten it, because it was powerful to see that, yeah, we didn't burn it, because we still believe that. Some of us still believe, a lot of us still believe that we burned it, just like some of y'all believe that the people in the South Bronx burned it. People still have that internal, blame, and that internal pain. So I'm hoping that we can overcome that by telling our own story, and I think that is just as